Good morning, Lincoln Lions. This is Mr. Conan. This is your daily announcements for Friday, March 30th, 2020. Every day, we'll be doing the pledge. Please stand for the pledge. 3, 2, 1.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Fantastic. We hope you had a great weekend. We're going to start off this weekend or this week with our Lincoln Spirit. On three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Lincoln Spirit makes us proud. Respectful lions above the crowd. Our spirit makes us try our best and challenges us to encourage the rest. We're going to talk about courage in a little bit here with my superhero piece, because today is Superhero Day. So here's some announcements. Students, keep working hard. Continue to step up in completing your work, as you'll be handing in your first packets from the last 2 weeks on Thursday. You'll be getting a new packet, and your report cards are coming home for the end of third quarter. Can you believe it? Last Friday was the end of third quarter. If you've been doing all of your work online, make sure to continue to share and submit your work to your teacher. Teachers will be giving feedback on your work. Like I said earlier, we have a virtual Spirit Week. Today is Superhero Day. I chose to be Captain Brave. He spreads courage, and as you may not know, courage is contagious. I will be wearing this, a cape, all day. We want to see what you're wearing today for Superhero Day. Tomorrow's sports day, so make sure you're wearing some type of a sporting outfit and take pictures and post or send to me or your classroom teachers. Another event coming up is an Easter egg hunt. This Saturday, we'll be doing an Easter egg hunt. You can design an Easter egg in any fashion you'd like. I'm sure your parents would love a lot of glitter. Place it in your window of your house so it is visible. Then on Saturday, you can walk with your family or drive around your neighborhood looking for eggs. This is being done district-wide, so any neighborhood in Great Falls would work. Teachers, we have a quick virtual staff meeting. This is just for instructional staff. This will be at today at 10 o'clock, just to give you an update since our last meeting that we had and the impact from the shelter in place from the governor. We talk a little bit more about how that affects us in school. So I'll send out a link around 9:45 a.m. for that Zoom meeting. Oh, parenting tip. Again, this is a part two from last Friday's parenting tip. This one comes from a fabulous parent and teacher extraordinaire, Miss Molly Beck. She said, the best thing that parents can do right now is be present. It's always your best strategy. During this time of uncertainty, when so many parents are asking what it is that they should be doing for their children, tell them this. Don't rush. Don't think about the 10 other things you still need to do. Stay in the moment. When you're giving a child a bath, enjoy the bath too. Feel the warm water, smell the shampoo, splash, play, linger for a while, but don't move on. Be present with your child. Positive warrior. John Gordon, a well-known motivational speaker and author, talks about being positive, not because life is easy, but because life is hard. I believe we must be finding the positives not only at home, but also outside of the walls of our house. You may find a positive with a brother or sister or parent or guardian or someone you don't even know. We're going to continue to keep celebrating our driving parade. All pictures kept coming in over the weekend for me and to me, so I want to be able to celebrate all those people. So many families made signs of kindness towards our school and towards specific teachers. It was fantastic. I'm going to start posting a lot of those pictures that I've collected over the weekend. I'm going to start posting them today. So for Positive Warrior, please send me, your teacher, or have your parents post on Facebook your Positive Warrior acts so we can continue to celebrate them on announcements each day. I believe this world needs more positives. Help me be a positive warrior. Book of the Day. Each day we'll be reading a story for you. Today I have a fabulous guest reader. This story is from Scholastic, so just making sure that everyone knows, once you read a Scholastic story and submit the title and author to Scholastic, you are allowed to read it. So I have a fabulous guest reader today. It is our band and orchestra leader, Miss Schaefer. She'll be reading for us Bats in the Band, illustrated and written by Brian Lies. Come on over, Miss Schaefer.
Good morning, everybody. This is Bats in the Band. In hibernation, we rest asleep through icy months of storm, still, still huddled together and waiting for weather to warm. But as the wicked winter thaws, we stretch our wings and shake our claws. Hunger drives us to the air. We've got to eat, no time to spare. We sing for our supper in brightening mood. Swooping and diving, we're finding our food. There isn't a menu. We play it by ear, chirping and chasing the echoes we hear. But each of us senses that something's not right. And then when a bugle blast shatters the night, that one lonely note tells us just what is wrong. We're hungry for sound. We've been silent too long. Relief on our faces is easy to read. A little night music is just what we need. And every last one of us knows where to go. A summertime theater after a show. We're chasing each other. Come on, look alive. Nobody wants to be the last to arrive. But as we approach it, there aren't any lights. We can't be mistaken. We know it's tonight. We circle above, then a window's thrown wide. It lights up the lawn and leads us inside. We swoop through the window, ignoring the bats, offering t-shirts, posters, and hats. A musical feast awaits us within. Why would we stop? We can't wait to begin. The space we fly into is warm and inviting. We set up the stages and fiddle with lighting. Some bats have instruments perfect in size. Others without them will just improvise. Behind the stage curtain, they're getting in tune, making up things out of straws, out of spoons. Other bat instruments come from afar, like curly horns, bagpipes, or dreamy sitar. And then when a bugle blast echoes once more, we stop what we're doing and flock to the floor. The conductor approaches. He lifts his baton. We all take a breath, and the concert is on. We sing together as one voice. It seems the very walls rejoice. All together, rafters ringing, it's as though our souls are singing. Then violins, viola, cello, change the mood to sweet and mellow. If you haven't seen a bat quartet, you really ain't seen nothing yet. The one-man bat band plays many things, at once with feet and breath and wings. And though we think this bat's inspired, watching leaves us feeling tired. Next up, there's a country song. Some lonesome bat done someone wrong. He's gone and broken someone's heart. Now everything has come apart. In a corner tucked away and far from where the others play, there's something for the younger set, who can't sit through a concert yet. Over there a singer cries of lonely days and empty skies. Her feelings fill the room with blue, and soon we find we're crying too. It's hard to figure, eyes get wetter, so how is it that we feel better? Now on the main stage, there's a hum of air guitar and blazing drums. Hearts are pumping, drums are thumping, everything that's loose is jumping. Can others hear us? We don't care. Let our spirits fill the air. Everybody joins the beat, clapping wings and stomping feet. We bounce, we hop, we twirl, we groove. The music makes our bodies move. But daylight through the window says it's time for us to go. So every bat who's willing crowds the stage to end our show. The music soars, finale's here, the ending of the song. It builds and builds, now here it comes. It's going, going, gong. Then the shimmering vibrations dwindle down and fade away, and a silence fills our ears, as loud as anything we've played. A weary cheer, there's nothing more, but no one wants to leave. Our music was a gift we gave and one that we received. But finally, we've got to go. We stretch and wave goodbye. Worn out, wrung out, half asleep, we greet the morning sky. Heading for home, we hum or we sing and discover there's music in everything. The roar of a car or the bark of a pup, the sound of the rest of the world waking up. But our night is over, the summons of sleep is pulling us downward, drowsy and deep. And as we nod off, the last thing we hear is the sound of our hearts beating time in our ears. And though we stay silent all through the day, up in the rafters and sleeping, we sway. It's not our intention, but you understand. We're dreaming of being the bats in the band. Okay, you guys, a couple of questions for you. What instrument would you like to play in the band? Do you think it would be difficult to play upside down? String players, do not try to play your instruments upside down. We know how important music is to us and how it makes us feel. So how are you enjoying music at home? Bye, you guys.
Thank you, Ms. Schaefer. What a fabulous book. I love those questions as well. As you know, I'm trying to incorporate music every single day. And I love having kids be able to do the song of the day for us. Today's song is a motivational song that comes from the Accra Girls, and they wanted you to go out and to be a champion today. So let's celebrate by playing Carrie Wood's song, Champion. Go be a positive warrior and go Lion Pride.